All right, guys, it's day two, and we are on our way to Little Rock, Arkansas. We absolutely crushed Texas yesterday. All the love that we got in Texas was tremendous. From Jackson from Renata Salon picked us up at the airport. He took us out to shoot some guns with Glock Dave. He also brought us to his barbershop, which is an old 1800 Victorian house. Really epic, really good people, him and his wife, Lauren. And then from there, we jumped back in the RV, shot about an hour away to Rowlett, Texas, where we met the guys from Redemption. Went out to dinner with them, showed us around the town. Really cool, small town in Texas. If you're ever in that area, I suggest you go there. If you like small, cool towns, definitely on the rise. And then they were even nice enough. They let us plug our RV into their barbershop that night. Mad love for Texas. Big shout out to Redemption and Renata Salon. You guys rock, a lot of hospitality. Now we're on to Handlebar Barbershop, Little Rock, Arkansas. We're heading there now. We're about 3 hours away. We just stopped at the Metro Diner to get some eggs and sausage, biscuits and gravy, and it was delicious. That's pretty much it. Alright, so we just pulled up to Handle Barbershop and been driving for like 7 hours. We're freaking shot. They're partying in there, so we're gonna go check them out, see what they got going on. Hopefully they got some food and some drinks, because we're ready to fucking party, baby. All I gotta say is that on the way here, Box edited up every single thing that we shot yesterday.
Yeah.
Renata Salon, Redemption Barbershop, full-blown vlog, 6 in the morning to 10 o'clock at night.
It's starting to get crazy, but I'm having a great time.
We're gonna go into Handlebar right now and film some more. Y'all ready for this? Alright, paying for some parking, gonna find ourselves some scooters. Skit, scat, doodle all over this bitch.
We decided to take a quick stop into Memphis, Tennessee. Maddie heard they had a crazy strip. The nightlife is crazy out here. We were just gonna drive through in the RV. We started noticing that they had these scooters right here on every corner. And for those of you who don't know what these are public scooters. They're electric scooters. They go about 20 miles per hour and you can actually rent them by the minute. A lot of people use it for public transportation in small cities or in big cities like this. We're gonna slap the 360 camera on it also. So we just paid for parking in this sketchy ass parking lot and we're gonna go find some scooters. You guys come along for the ride.
On top of the world, baby!
Alright, so we're on top of some crazy parking garage in the middle of Memphis. We got some electric scooters. How we got here?
It's fucking wild. Make a time lapse out of this. Day three, we just got up, getting our stuff together, and we're gonna head out to St. Louis. Stopped in Memphis last night, really good time. So off to Union Barbershop. We're gonna stop by our buddy Eric from Relentless. He does all of our screen printing. That's it, back on the move, on the road again. Just really happy with this whole trip, is panning out, making so many connections, meeting so many good people. Everybody's just showing us so much love. It's a really good feeling. Everybody's expecting us. The hospitality has just been great everywhere that we went. Definitely the best decision we made was to grab this RV. It's just the convenience factor is unbelievable. It would have really sucked to have to lug our baggage in and out of hotels. And it's cool. Box Visual is able to edit as we move. It's just so convenient. It's just saving us so much time. Checking in and out of hotels, finding parking garages and everything like that. We're just able to get in our truck, drive. We don't feel like driving anymore. Pull into a lot, crash, get up and keep going. Got a really cool app. It's called RV Parky. If you ever drive across country and you have an RV, or even if you can do it in a van, Shows you all the spots you can sleep. Last night we stayed at a casino in Memphis. Got about 2.5 hours now until we hit St. Louis. We're gonna kind of take our time. We're really in no rush. We're riding perpendicular to the Mississippi River, so we're gonna find a spot where we come the closest to it. Maybe we'll throw the drone up over it and check it out. And that's it. Just wanted to give you guys a little update where we're at, and we'll touch back base when we get to the river. Like I always say, you're never gonna get a good shot unless you fly a little dangerously. And right now, here's a perfect example of that. We're trying to get some shots over the Mississippi River, and my drone is currently stuck in a tree.
Oh shit.
Probably gonna have to climb a tree. Sounds like it's pretty far.
All right, Maddie.
This is the annoying thing about being a videographer and doing crazy amazing shoots on location, but hey. There's barbed wire right here. Got it? Oh, I see it. So we got some damage to all four props are broken. This one's just a little chipped up. This one would actually still fly, but we're gonna have to get a replacement. It looks like the props took all the damage.
Which, right here too.
Yeah, that was close to hitting my sensor too. So
all right, well,
I think for what we did, I think
it was the best case scenario.
Yeah, best case scenario. No experienced flyer. Hasn't crashed a couple drones before.
All right, we're all fueled up. We got new wings for the drone. Everything seems to be okay. Gimbal's working and everything. So right now we're about an hour from St. Louis. We head over to Union Barbershop, meet those guys, make a video. I have a small time frame that they're able to be there because they're actually off today and they took the day, kind of all come to the shop just to meet us. So yeah, like I said, we got about an hour and a half left. We're gonna hit the road. And then when we get there, we're gonna make an epic video that you're about to see right now. So right now I'm about to go send the drone up, right? You're not gonna crash it this time?
You think I'm gonna fucking crash
it? We need that baby for Niagara Falls.
Nah, yeah, but definitely we'll be alright. We got new props. Again, it didn't take much damage, so I'm obviously not gonna crash it again.
Spirits aren't as high as they usually are in the RV today. What happened, Box?
There's a bad times and then there's good times. Most of this trip was a good time. This probably is, this is a sad time. Today, as you guys already know in the vlog, we crashed the drone on the Mississippi River in a tree. And we recovered it with no damage whatsoever.
A little
besides
damage.
The four props, which were completely replaceable.
Went to Best Buy and bought new props.
We got new props. And then the exact first time I flew the drone after crashing it, in front of Union Barbershop, I wound up crashing the drone again. Not only crashing it, but now it's stranded on top of a 55-foot church roof. Have you ever, like, saved your child from drowning and then later that day accidentally
dropped them back in the pool?
It's
the first time he spoke since it happened. We do have some things that give me great hope. The people from Union says they got all the connections in the world. If we could scale up that gutter.
I mean, if we gotta wait till tomorrow, we... always has
well, it's only one way to find out. So we're pulling up to Relentless now. We're gonna go check it out. They got some cool automatic screen printers that I've been dying to see. Relentless Custom Printing. It's a good buddy of mine that used to live on Long Island and he moved out to St. Louis and he prints all of our t-shirts. He does all of our apparel. We're gonna check out their facility, go out to eat with them, and we're probably gonna crash with them tonight and roll out in the morning. One way or another, you're gonna see us on the motherfucking roof. Thank you.
All right, buddy. We just woke up. We're at our friend Eric's house. We slept here last night in a real bed and a real shower. It was really nice. Head back to our RV. We're gonna head over to Union Barbershop and see if we can pull that drone up off the roof. And then we're heading out to Louisville. Rox, how you feel about your drone being up on the roof all night?
I feel bad, man. It's gotta be cold up there. What happens if you don't get it? I got one on the bottom of Hudson River.
At least you got it in a cool spot.
I'm leaving my mark everywhere.
We talked to Megan this morning. She told us that the guy that owns the building has a smaller ladder, but we could try to use it. If there's any ladder, we're gonna make it happen. Even if we have to drive this RV onto the sidewalk and put the ladder up on the roof, we're getting that drone.
All right, so we're here, we're back at Union. The guy that owns the church, his name's Abraham, was really nice. He gave us this, I don't know, maybe 30-foot ladder, 25-foot ladder. I don't think it's gonna be enough to make it. We're gonna try it out here first, and then we'll go around back. There's some scaffolding set up back there if we have to use two ladders.
Drone's right there.
On top of the church. I got cotton mouth because I'm nervous as a motherfucker. Haven't been on a roof this tall in a long time. Headed to see the shit. So I'm only made it to the other side of the roof. All right, I'm gonna go down there. Wish me luck. Got the drone. Gimbal looks like it's still intact. I broke a few wings. We're off Union Barbershop. I gotta walk back across this. And then I'm home free home. Just gotta climb down that fucking sketchy ass ladder.
How'd you do?
She did good, bro. This drone has seen a lot. I feel really bad. So you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna clean her off real nice, pack her away in a case, and then take the day off.
She got a couple dings. I broke all my props again. So this one's completely gone somewhere in the gutter. All these are pretty much chipped up.
This one's shot. Oh, yeah.
I scratched the shit out of the battery. The arms are pretty scratched up.
We got it back.
Most importantly, we got it back and this little guy isn't scratched up. Somehow, like the most delicate part is never broken, which is crazy.